For what purpose does a gentlewoman from New Mexico seek recognition?
Madam Speaker, I move that the House suspend the rules and pass the bill S-108.
The clerk will report the title of the bill.
Senate 108, an act to authorize the Seminole Tribe of Florida to lease or transfer certain land and for other purposes.
Pursuant to the rule, the gentlewoman from New Mexico, Ms. Leger Fernandez, and the gentleman from Arkansas, Mr. Westerman, each will control 20 minutes. The chair recognizes the gentlewoman from New Mexico.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I ask unanimous consent that all members may have 5 legislative days in which to revise and extend their remarks and include extraneous material on the measure under consideration.
Without objection.
Madam Speaker, I yield myself such time as I may consume.
The gentlewoman is recognized.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Senate 108, introduced by Senator Rubio of Florida, will allow the Seminole Tribe of Florida to lease, sell, convey, warrant, or transfer its real property that is not held in trust by the United States. The Seminole Tribe of Florida is a federally recognized tribe with its tribal headquarters located in Hollywood, Florida. It is one of 3 federally recognized Seminole Indians, and many of its enrolled members reside on its 6 reservations in Florida. In recent decades, a large portion of the tribe's economic development strategy has been its investment in commercial real estate properties. So far, the tribe owns one of the largest cattle operations in the U.S., along with the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino franchise and its 74 international properties. To manage the tribe's growing portfolio, the Tribal Council established a commercial real estate investments fund to help create generational stability for the Seminole tribe. Ultimately, the tribe's hope is to establish a state-chartered subsidiary entity to act as a holding company for certain properties owned by the tribe. Unfortunately, the tribe has been unable to move forward with this project due to concerns raised by lenders and proposed title insurance companies about the Indian Non-Intercourse Act. The act prohibits any, quote, purchase, grant, lease, or other conveyance of lands or of any title claimed thereto from an Indian nation or tribe of Indians unless authorized by Congress. At least 2 title insurance companies approached by the tribe have interpreted the act to apply to real estate owned by a state-chartered subsidiary entity of the tribe. As such, the title companies will not insure the mortgage without an exemption from the act, which in turn effectively kills any ability to finance an acquisition. Senate 108 will therefore provide relief from the Indian Non-Intercourse Act by clarifying that the Seminole Tribe of Florida has the authority to lease, sell, convey, warrant, or otherwise transfer their interests in property not held in trust by the federal government without further approval from the federal government. This bipartisan effort is led in the House by my colleague, Representative Darren Soto of Florida, who is the sponsor of the House companion bill. I congratulate him on his strong advocacy to get this legislation to the President's desk. S-108 will allow the Seminole Tribe the ability to continue its economic development, and I urge my colleagues to vote in favor of this bill. I reserve the balance of my time.
The gentleman from Arkansas is recognized.
I yield myself as much time as I may consume.
The gentleman is recognized.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I also want to thank Chairman Grijalva and Chairwoman Leger Fernandez for working together on this bill. It's a bill that I rise in support, Senate Bill 108. It's a bill that authorizes the Seminole Tribe of Florida to lease or transfer certain land and for other purposes. Ms. Leger Fernandez described, this bill would exempt lands held in fee by the Seminole Tribe of Florida from the limitations imposed by the Indian Non-Intercourse Act, which restricts a tribe from leasing or conveying any lands a tribe owns without federal approval. The act has generated a great deal of confusion and litigation about whether a tribe can buy, sell, or lease land that it owns. The bill states that the act does not authorize the tribe to lease, sell, convey, warrant, or otherwise transfer all or any portion of any interest in any real property that is held in trust. This bill was introduced in response to real estate investment issues encountered by the Seminole Tribe, since at least 2 title insurance companies would not grant the tribe insurance. The bill ensures that the act does not interfere with the ability to convey fee land owned by the tribe, which would impede the tribe's economic development activities and hinder job creation. I urge adoption of the measure and reserve the balance of my time.
The gentleman reserves. The gentlewoman from New Mexico is recognized.
I reserve.
The gentlewoman reserves. The gentleman from Arkansas is recognized.
Madam Speaker, we're ready to close. Again, I urge adoption of this measure, and I yield back the balance of my time.
The gentleman yields back. The gentlewoman from New Mexico is recognized.
Madam Speaker, I am grateful for this bipartisan legislation. I also think it gives us a path forward on how what we might need to do for all tribes who encounter this issue. But for now, I am very much in support of S-108 and urge my colleagues to support the legislation. And I yield back the balance of my time.
The gentlewoman yields back. The question is, will the House suspend the rules and pass Senate 108? Those in favor say aye. Those opposed, no. In the opinion of the chair, two-thirds being in the affirmative, the rule, the gentleman from Virginia.
Request recorded vote, please.
To Section 3S of House Resolution 8, the yeas and nays are ordered. Pursuant to Clause 8 of Rule 20, further proceedings on this question will be postponed.